Hey everyone, welcome back to the channel, and today we'll be doing an unboxing and review video for the 1/6 scale Serene Hound Catherine figure by i8toys. This is an original designer piece that's not based on any video game or movie characters, but because of that, it's also one of the funnest pieces that I've ever had the pleasure of owning. Throughout the 2010s, a studio known as Original Effects had been producing a unique line of 6-scale female figures. Each were built from a custom sculpted body, featuring manga-styled faces and over-the-top costumes. Not to be confused with the video game franchise of the same name, one of the series from the studio was called Killer Instinct or Killer Paradise, which was distinct for its post-apocalyptic military-themed characters. Original Effects eventually disbanded, but some of its creators went on to i8toys to continue their work, with a brand new series known as Serene Hound, which is a unit of hunters whose mission is to seek out and destroy a threat to humanity known as the Witch. Original series like this aren't very common in this hobby, and if I wasn't just a pair of disembodied hands, I'd be patting myself on the back, because the price of this figure skyrocketed in the few months after its release in 2020, and I happened to snag a copy right before the price surge. There really isn't any likeness to speak of, since it's not based on anything, but the style for this head sculpt is very consistent with the concept art that inspired it. It's a strange mix of manga-styled facial features with realistic paint application, and I think they work really well here. The hair sculpt looks really good, but sadly, its implementation is the single biggest gripe I have with this figure, because it can chip off the face paint if you're not careful. And it's all due to the fact that the entire hair piece must be removed in order to access the movable eyes, which is arguably the coolest feature of this figure. The bangs are really close to the face, so you have to pull apart the hair first, then carefully lift it up and away from the face, then remove the head and neck to access the eye pegs. Doing this repeatedly could wear down the paint on the face, unless you use a piece of paper as buffer as per the instructions. But I'd argue a better design is to split the hair sculpt into a front and a back piece, like with the Sanadi figure that I reviewed before. Having the hair sculpted like a helmet literally just adds friction between setting up and enjoying the display. Anyway, that's all I have to rant about, so let's move on to the cooler bits, which is basically everything else. The costume is very reminiscent of Sophia from the aforementioned Killer Instinct series. And it's no surprise, because I think this white top with a navy blue skirt is a winning combination. The harness looks great as well, but do watch out for the glued-on buttons. The vambraces are really intricate even though they are not at all practical. But really, looking good is all that matters when it comes to these fantasy characters. Catherine is actually wearing a button-down bodysuit, so don't at me in the comments for what might look like creep shots in this video. Like with the vambraces, the leg guards and knee pads are as impractical as they are stylish. And I love the contrast between the orange laces and these army green boots, which of course comes with a set of working zippers. And finally, we have this beautiful fur collar parka, which is threaded with a full body strap, along with working buckles and zippers. This thing brings a fresh sense of film noir dynamic to the figure, and it goes to show just how well the designers were able to execute their vision with this release. Ditching the sculpted body from the Original Effect era, i8toys opted for a more traditional 6-scale figure body for this release. It's tight and weighty, and it's seamless only for the exposed parts, such as the elbows. Catherine can move her legs pretty far without tugging the bodysuit, thanks to the separate pelvis joints. The knee joints are ratcheted with a somewhat modest bend. These rather thick boots do hinder ankle articulations, but Catherine stands pretty well on her own, so it's not too big a deal that this release didn't come with a display base. But I did end up using one of my spares anyway, because all the fun poses required some kind of dynamic footwork. The accessories are pretty bare bones. Besides the hand parts, all we have is this tan-colored MP7-1A submachine gun. But this thing is packed to the brim with options, starting with the collapsible iron sights, standard muzzle base, retractable stock, vertical foregrip, sound suppressor, red dot reflex sights, and a PEG-15 laser aiming module, with an external pressure switch that doesn't really fit in Catherine's tiny gun-holding hands, nor does it fit anywhere on the frame, so I just left it out. Besides, this weapon looks really cool no matter how you configure it. So there you have it, the 1/6 scale Serene Hound Catherine figure by i8toys. Unlike most other figures, I'm not confined into doing a certain pose or recreating an iconic scene just to have fun. It reminds me of the more primal joys of owning an action figure, where your imagination is the only limit as to how you want to play with it. Sadly, the less than perfect implementations for the movable eyes makes this piece hardly worth the insane aftermarket prices. But if you want something similar, you're in luck, because i8 Toys is going strong with this line, and they've announced a few upcoming entries for this series. But if you happen to spot Catherine in the wild at a reasonable price, definitely don't sleep on it. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.